Learn the best optimization methods to boost FPS and make Windows faster, as well as optimize your PC and get more FPS for gaming. In the first method, you will disable full screen optimizations in games. First, open the game you want to optimize, then press Windows and G on the keyboard to minimize it. Now, right click on the taskbar and then click on Task Manager. After that, select Details, then under the search bar in the upper corner, type the name of the game. If there is more than one process for your game, you will choose the one that is using the most CPU and memory. After that, write down the process name because you will need it for the second method. Now, right click on the chosen process and click on Open File Location. Then, right click on the file with the same name as the game process. Now, click on Properties. After that, select the Compatibility tab. Now, check the box under Disable Full Screen Optimizations. And lastly, click on Apply and OK. In the second method, you will create a DWORD value in Regedit to make your games run with high priority permanently. First, click on the Windows icon. Now, in the search bar, type Regedit. After that, click on the corresponding option. Under this field, you will need to paste the address that I will leave in the description below. Now, press Enter on the keyboard to access it. After that, you should right click on the Image File Execution Options key, then click on New and Key. Now, you will name this key the same as the process name of your chosen game. You can find the process name of each of your games by following the steps in the first method. After that, press Enter on the keyboard to save it. Now, right-click on the key that you've created, then click on New and Key. After that, name this key as Perf Options, and then press Enter on the keyboard to save it. Now, you must right-click on the Perf Options key, and then click on New and DWORD 32-bit value. After that, you will see a new DWORD value in the upper corner, then name it as CPU Priority Class, and then press Enter on the keyboard to save it. Now, right-click on the CPU Priority Class DWORD value, and then click on Modify, and lastly, inside of its data, you will type 3 to set high priority, and then click on OK to save it. In the third method, you will enable optimized graphic settings and set the high performance GPU preference for games. First, click on the Windows icon. Now, in the search bar, type graphics. After that, click on the corresponding option. Now, make sure that optimizations for Windows games is enabled. Then, click on advanced settings to expand it. Now, make sure that hardware accelerated GPU scheduling is enabled. And then, disable the variable refresh rate option. Now, under search this list, type the name of your game. Once you find it, click on it to expand the other options. Then, under GPU preference, select high performance. And lastly, make sure that optimizations for Windows games is enabled. In the fourth method, you will get more FPS and reduce ping in games with no ping. First, access no ping using the link in the description and pinned comment below. Now, click on Try 7 days free, and then create a free account for 7 days. After that, click on Download, and then Download for Windows. Now you will have to install it by right-clicking on the setup file and clicking on Open. The installation process is very simple, just follow each step. After that, you can open NoPing and log in to your account. Now click on Boost FPS under Hardware. In this section, you will see several optimization methods to get more FPS in games. The following optimizations are the best in my opinion. Disable Windows Game Bar, remove network bandwidth limits, disable power saving features, optimize processor, disable visual effects, and optimize network adapter settings. And I don't recommend you to enable some optimizations like disable Windows Update, as it's better to keep your system up to date. Be careful toggle with optimizations that have the feature break-ins warning. Now click on PC under connection. Here you can optimize and select the best connection route for your games. This is important because the default route to the game server may not be the best and may be congested by other devices, increasing your ping and causing packet loss. Now just type the name of your game in search for a game, for example Valorant. Once you find your game, click on its image where it says choose server. Here you will find several servers around the world that you can connect to and optimize your route. By default, no ping will indicate the best server to reduce your ping, but you can select it manually by clicking on the desired server or activating advanced mode to create a custom route. In my case, I will leave the route that no ping selected, then just click on optimize game and it will automatically connect you to the selected server. A graph with ping information will now be displayed so you can see the difference between having no ping connection route optimization enabled and disabled. And this is the performance and connection test in Valorant after enabling no ping optimizations. In the fifth method, you will optimize the settings in the NVIDIA app. First, click on the Windows icon, search for NVIDIA app, and then click on the corresponding option. Now select graphics and global settings, RTX dynamic vibrance, select off, CUDA GPUs, select all available GPUs, under DLSS, override model presets, frame generation mode, and super resolution mode, select use the 3D application setting, DSR factors, select off. I don't have an RTX GPU, so smooth motion is not supported. Low latency mode, select ultra, to lower input latency in games, image scaling, select on, and choose a render resolution percentage. Next to it, you will see a new resolution, so you need to open your game settings and change the resolution to the same as the render resolution you chose. Max frame rate, select off, monitor technology, select G-Sync compatible, OpenGL DDI compatibility, select prefer performance, Vulkan OpenGL present method, select auto, power management mode, select prefer maximum performance, shader cache size, select unlimited, vertical sync, select use the 3D application setting, virtual reality, variable rate super sampling, select off. Now click on show legacy settings, anisotropic filtering, select application controlled, anti-aliasing FXAA, select off, anti-aliasing transparency, select multi-sample, background application max frame rate, select off, multi-frame sample JA, MFAA, select off, physics processor, select your NVIDIA GPU, texture filtering, anisotropic sample optimization, select on, texture filtering, negative load bias, select allow, texture filtering quality, select high performance, and texture filtering trilinear optimization, select on. In the sixth method, you will enable game mode. First, click on the Windows icon. Now, in the search bar, type game mode. After that, click on the corresponding option, and then make sure that game mode is enabled. In the seventh method, you will set the high performance power plan. First, click on the Windows icon. Now, in the search bar, type powercfg.cpl. After that, click on the corresponding option. Now, if you have your processor chipset driver installed, you will notice its power plans. If you don't have the chipset driver for your processor installed, I will leave a link in the description below to the AMD and Intel website where you can download and install the chipset driver. After that, you need to select the high performance power plan from your processor. In my case, I have an AMD processor, so I will select AMD Ryzen High Performance. And then, if after installing the chipset driver, your processor's power plan doesn't appear, you can select the Windows default high performance power plan. In the eighth method, you will optimize all drives on your computer. First, click on the Windows icon. Now, in the search bar, type GFR GUI. After that, click on the corresponding option. Now, you should select each drive and click on optimize, and then do this until you have optimized all the drives on your PC. In the ninth method, you will reduce start up apps. First, right click on the task bar and then click on task manager. Now select start up apps and then disable all apps that you don't need to start when you turn on your PC. In the 10th method, you will disable Windows background apps. First, click on the Windows icon. Now in the search bar, type gpedit.msc. After that, click on the corresponding option, then navigate to Computer Configuration, Administrative Templates, Windows Components, and App Privacy. Now double-click on Let Windows Apps Run in the Background, then select Enabled in the upper left corner under Default for All Apps, select Force Deny, and then click on Apply and OK. In the 11th method, you will check the integrity of Windows system files and fix them if there are any issues. First, right-click on the Windows icon, then you should click on Terminal Admin. After opening the terminal, you should first check and repair the Windows image file, then type gism /online /cleanup-image /restore-health, and then press Enter to run it. Now just wait for the process to finish. After that, you can check and repair the system files, then type sfc /scan now. Now press Enter again to run it, and then you just need to wait for the process to finish. In the 12th method, you will change the DNS servers and clear the DNS cache. First, click on the Windows icon. Now in the search bar, type ncpa.cpl. After that, click on the corresponding option. Then, right-click on the Ethernet device and click on Properties. Now select Internet Protocol version 4 and click on Properties. After that, check use the following DNS server addresses. Then, under Preferred DNS Server, type 1.1.1.1, and under Alternate DNS Server, type 8.8.8.8. Then click on OK and Close. After that, right-click on the Windows icon. Now you should click on Terminal and then type ipconfig /flushdns and press Enter. In the 13th method, you will clean up Windows temporary files. First, click on the Windows icon. Now in the search bar, type delete temporary files. After that, click on the corresponding option. Now click on temporary files, then uncheck the files that you don't want to delete, such as downloads and recycle bin. Do not check the files you want to keep, as they will be deleted and cannot be recoverable. After that, click on remove files and continue to delete them. In the 14th method, you will set a higher display refresh rate. First, right-click on the desktop and click on Display Settings. Now, scroll down and click on Advanced Display, and then under Choose a Refresh Rate, select the highest available. In the 15th method, you will disable Windows Transparency Effects. First, right-click on the desktop and click on Personalize. Now, click on Colors and then disable Transparency Effects. In the 16th method, you will disable power saving on your network adapter. First, open the network connections panel as in the 12th method, right-click on the Ethernet device and click on Properties. After that, click on Configure and select Power Management. Now, uncheck Allow your computer to turn off this device to save power. Then, select Advanced. Now, click on Energy Efficient Ethernet and set it to disabled, and then click on OK. In the 17th method, you will optimize your Windows mouse settings. First, click on the Windows icon. Now, in the search bar, type main.cpl. After that, click on the corresponding option. Now, select Pointer Options and uncheck Enhance Pointer Precision, and then click on Apply and OK. In the 18th method, you will improve the sound quality of Windows. First, click on the Windows icon. Now in the search bar, type mmsys.cpl. After that, click on the corresponding option, then double click on the default playback device. Now click on Advanced, and then under default format, select the highest bit depth depth and sample rate in Hertz 8Z available. In the 19th method, you will disable the high precision event timer. First, right-click on the Windows icon, then click on Device Manager. After that, expand System Devices. Now right-click on High Precision Event Timer and then click on Disable Device and Yes. In the 20th method, you will check for Windows Updates. First, search for Updates and click on Check for Updates and then click on Check for Updates and install all available updates. And that was the video. Let me know in the comment section below if this video was helpful to you. If you want to boost and optimize performance in other games, you can subscribe to this channel and then always learn new methods when I upload new videos. Thanks for watching, see you in the next video.